Hey folks, it's Greg here for GS Vervine, and today I'm going on a little trip along what I consider to be one of the most beautiful drives in Metro Vancouver. It's along Marine Drive, and it's on the southwest coastline of Metro Vancouver. It's going to be a wonderful trip, and today I'm using my new Panasonic G85. Well, actually, I use that camera for my Garden of Eden video, if you saw it. If you didn't see it, look at the end of this video and I have a link to it. And I love this camera. It's really light and sharp, and well, let's see how it turns out. Let's go. Well folks, I'm here in Horseshoe Bay having an ice cream and just taking in the sun, and I'm on my way to Marine Drive, and here comes my ice cream. Nothing like a good... Hey, somebody bit half of my ice cream off. I wonder who that is. There's nothing like having a good ice cream on a hot day with the sun in your eyes.
Je peux vous le rendre, Seigneur, Seigneur, car avec les soldats, il est toreros, devait s'entendre, pour plaisir, ils ont les combats. Le cirque est plein ce jour de fête, le cirque est plein d'automats. Le spectateur,
well folks, that's about it for my drive along Marine Drive, and I'm on my way back home. Well folks, I'm back from my Marine Drive little tour, and I'm going to do some cooking. Today I'm going to do something called a tagine. And the tagine is a dish that's named after this cooking vessel, a tagine or tangine. And I have some ingredients here. Now you can cook with any kind of meat that you want. Today I'm going to use some tender lamb. And I have my ingredients laid out here. I'll give you a list
after the dish is finished. But I'll just tell you quickly here, I have a grater for grating this onion, which will be the bed for the tagine. I have some tender lamb, coriander and parsley, salted clemency, you can use lemon also, turnip, jicama, green peas, figs, dried apricot, dried pear, cashews, almond, 2 cloves of garlic, and that's about it. So I'm going to prepare this stuff and I'll come back and we'll put everything together. Okay, so I've prepared everything. I've blended up my celery, parsley and coriander. I'm prepared with my green beans, green peas, my lamb. I've prepared some lemons and some preserved clemency. And I have all my ingredients here. Okay, so let's put it together. It's my seasoning that I made previously. I'll just put it all on the lamb. Mix it in well. Make sure all the pieces are coated. Now you can do this and leave this overnight so that you have a better flavor on the meat. I'm not going to do that because I'm just doing this quickly as a quick lunch. And I'm happy with that. That's done. And now for the next stage. Okay, so a little bit of olive oil at the bottom of the tagine, just to make sure things don't, you know, get stuck. Move it around a little bit. You don't want to put too much. You're not frying it. And next, onions. Just cover the base of the tagine with onions that you previously sliced up. You can put as much as you want, as long as you cover the bottom. Then we put the meat over the onions. This would ensure that the meat does not get burnt and stuck to the bottom of the tagine. Although that should not be likely if you do it right, because once you cover the tagine, there's a lot of moisture that comes down from the cone-shaped top into the wider base. Okay, so once we are done with that, our vegetables, we go on top of the meat, just throw it in a nice little pattern so that you get as much in as possible. I'll put all the ingredients that I use and all the alternatives that you can use for your area. You may not be able to find everything. So I just toss these cashews and almonds at the top. Everything pretty much goes on top of it. Pieces of pickled clemency and lemon. And lastly, my green peas. And there you have it. Now we'll just cover the tagine and put it on the stove. Put the lid on. And I've used a ring on this burner because I don't want the heat to come in contact with, direct contact with the tagine. This is made of clay, it's baked clay, so there is a limit to the temperature that it would withstand. So let's do that now, put it on the stove. Medium heat until the tagine begins to steam. You'll see some steam coming out of the edges, and then you just turn the temperature down to, well, on my stove, to 3. So that's about midway between medium and low. And let it cook for about 40-45 minutes. And there you have it, folks. That's tagine. Next, I'm going to do some couscous, and I think today I'll make some sangria, red wine sangria, just to go with the meal. Okay, folks, well, let's make some couscous in 2 minutes. A bowl with couscous. It comes in a box. You can use half of it at a time if there are about 3 people, or the whole box if there are 4 people. Boiling water. Off the stove, of course. Couscous, well, you need some salt. Let's put the salt in first. Just about a teaspoon of salt. Bit of butter, just a little tablespoon of butter. And couscous. Cover it. And wait. How simple is that? Okay, folks, well, I've prepped everything up and I'm ready to put it together. Let's make a jug of sangria. I have my oranges. Actually, this time I used just one orange, cut up, sliced, one apple. One lemon, cut up into wedges. I'm going to squeeze this into the jug. Quarter cup of sugar, not much. We don't want it too sweet. Bottle of wine, red wine. I have more than one bottle because I'm going to put a little bit of what has been left over from a day or two ago. And orange juice. Now you can add triple sec to this. We don't, because we don't drink a lot of alcohol. So let's put it together now. First, the lemon. I'm just going to squeeze these wedges in. Seems like a lot of lemon, but in fact, it's just one. Then I'll add the apples, the oranges, and the sugar. Red wine. And some orange juice. Stir it up together. If you have a wider jug, maybe that's even better. I usually make it in this. And then I leave it for about a few hours. You can leave it overnight. As a matter of fact, they recommend that you leave it overnight. But I just make these things when I need it and when I feel like it, so I'm not going to prep it overnight and wait. And that's about it. Sangria. Well, folks, there you have it. Fluffy couscous, tagine, lamb tagine, and sangria. What a nice way to end a wonderful day. And you can do it all. I'll put the recipe in the link below. And have fun trying it. Remember, always be experimental and adventurous in your cooking. Don't get too intimidated by any dish, even though it may seem very complicated. Hey folks, well, you know, it's easy for me to say just whip out your tagine and start cooking up. But what if you're traveling and you don't have, usually you wouldn't carry all these things from your kitchen with you, and neither did I. I remember one time back several years ago, I was traveling and just felt like tagine. And I came up with this idea. Simple aluminum foil and an old bit of takeout food wrapping plate. Aluminum foil. There's always a good alternative. And most of all, stay active. Keep fit. Enjoy your life. See you in the next video. I just want to cry when I eat good food.